Hello and welcome to the TI Precision Lab Supplement for op-amp slew rate. This lab will walk through detailed calculations, SPICE simulations, and real-world measurements that greatly help to reinforce the concepts established in the op-amp slew rate video series. The detailed calculation portion of this lab can be done by hand, but calculation tools such as MathCAD or Excel can help greatly. The simulation exercises can be performed in any SPICE simulator, since TI provides generic SPICE models of the op-amps used in this lab. However, the simulations are most conveniently done in Tina TI, which is a free SPICE simulator available from the TI website. Tina simulation schematics are embedded in the presentation. Finally, the real-world measurements are made using a printed circuit board, or PCB, provided by TI. If you have access to standard lab equipment, you can make the necessary measurements with any oscilloscope, function generator, and plus or minus 15 volts power supply. However, we highly recommend the VirtualBench from National Instruments. The VirtualBench is an all-in-one test equipment solution which connects to a computer over USB or Wi-Fi and provides power supply rails, analog signal generator and oscilloscope channels, and a 5.5-digit multimeter for convenient and accurate measurements. This lab is optimized for use with the virtual bench. First, draw the output voltage waveform of the circuit shown below. Use the slew rate specifications given in the table and the techniques from the slew rate lecture. The answer is provided to allow you to check your work. The next step is to run a SPICE simulation analysis for the transient output voltage behavior. This will allow us to see the op-amp's output voltage response for a specified input signal, which in this case is a 5 volts peak, 10 kHz square wave. The necessary Tina TI simulation schematic is embedded in this slide set. Simply double-click the icon to open it. To simulate the transient output behavior, click Analysis, then Transient. Run the analysis from 0 to 200 microseconds. You should see a result similar to this. Vin is a square wave, as expected, but Vout must obey the slew rate limitations of the OPA-277. You can see this effect in the rise time from 10% to 90% of the output, or minus 4 volts to plus 4 volts. Use the cursors to measure the time required for the output to slew from minus 4 volts to 4 volts, and use the equation that slew rate equals delta Y over delta X to calculate the simulated slew rate of 0.7 volts per microsecond. Make sure to disable the DC power supply before setting up the test PCB. In the VirtualBench software, click the power button in the DC power supply area to turn off power. Also check the front panel of the VirtualBench unit to make sure the LEDs are off. Finally, make sure that the function generator is also off. To prepare the test board for the measurement, install the jumpers and devices on circuit 5 as shown here. Install JMP17, JMP18, and JMP20, as well as the OPA-277 in socket U7. This slide shows the full schematic for circuit 5 on the TI Precision Labs test board. You will use this circuit to measure the effect of slew rate limitations on the OPA-277. For the test board to function properly, it is important that you only install jumpers and devices in circuit 5. Do not install any jumpers or devices in any other circuits on the PCB. Remove any jumpers or devices from the unused circuits and store them in the storage area at the bottom of the test board. This gives the connection diagram between the TI Precision Labs test board and the National Instruments VirtualBench. Connect the provided power cable to the DC power supply of the VirtualBench and power connector J4 on the test board. Connect VIN2 on the test board to VirtualBench channel FGEN, or function generator. Then connect VN1 on the test board to VirtualBench oscilloscope channel 1, and VOUT1 on the test board to VirtualBench oscilloscope channel 2. Next, apply power to the VirtualBench and connect it to your computer with a USB cable. The hardware should be detected as a virtual CD drive, and you can run the VirtualBench software directly from the drive. Once the software opens, configure the software as follows. Set the time scale to 20 microseconds per division, with the acquisition mode set to auto. enable channels 1 and 2 on the oscilloscope, and set them to 1x DC coupled mode, 5 volts per division. Enable the function generator and set up the signal as follows. 10 kHz frequency, 10 volts peak to peak, 0 volts offset, 50% duty cycle, square wave. Set the plus 25 volt power supply to plus 15 volts, 0.5 amps. Set the minus 25 volt power supply to minus 15 volts, 0.5 amps. Press the power button to turn on the power supply rails. Let's now determine the measured slew rate. Enable cursors, set them up as shown, then place the cursors on 10% and 90% of the output signal. Take note of the time and voltage difference, and then calculate the slew rate using the equation given. In this example, a slew rate of 0.82 volts per microsecond was measured. You may have slightly different results in your experiment. Compare the oscilloscope display of the VirtualBench to the simulation results from Tina TI. Also compare the slew rate values from the datasheet, simulation, and measurement. They should all be similar, although you may get slightly different results. That concludes this lab. Thank you for your time.